here to give us his take on the GOP race, Republican Congressman Peter Roskam. Thanks for being here, Peter.
Thanks. Good to be here. Thank you.
And we want to talk about the State of the Union address tomorrow night as well. So many topics here. But first of all, what about, Newt Gingrich obviously won South Carolina in dramatic fashion. It seems like there's a surprise around every corner in this battle.
Yeah.
And it's, my question is this. Is it getting to the point now where it's so bruising and such a bloody battle that maybe you're doing the president's work for him in terms of, you know, carving up one another, looking forward to the general election?
I don't think so. I think you've had three primaries or caucuses and now three different winners that have emerged. And if you go back to 2008, when Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton were in a classic bruising battle for the nomination, I would argue that made Barack Obama a better candidate in the general election. So, look, if you're a Republican seeking the nomination for the presidency, it is supposed to be a long, difficult, arduous, miserable process, and it is. And if you can't beat one of these nominees, you're surely not going to, or one of these other candidates, you're sure not going to beat a sitting president.
Do you have a favorite?
I don't. My attitude is I want to see who emerges. I want to see these sorts of themes. And I want to see somebody who can draw a contrast with President Obama largely on the economy. How do we move this economy? And I think that there's some ideas that we can advance and advocate. And let's see who's the best advocate for that through this process.
Speaking of ideas, do you have something that you think the president should tackle in his State of the Union tomorrow? What are you expecting?
Well, two things. One is what do I hope and what do I expect? So let's start with what I would hope. I would hope that President Obama would say, we need to completely scrap the tax code and we need to focus in on tax reform that is competitive and dynamic, and I think the country is very, very open to that. It can happen in an election year. The last time in 1986, Ronald Reagan led us, and that bill was signed 2 weeks before a midterm election. I'd like to see him do that. I would also like to see the president reverse his decision on the Keystone Pipeline, because I think he made a bad choice last week. Now, do I think that's going to happen? No. I think the president is largely going to move into a fairly defensive posture where he continues to advocate policies that have not met the rhetoric and have not come to fruition in terms of economic growth.
Some of what he has to say tomorrow night has already been leaked to the press, and one of the lines was that he will offer ideas for building the economy that, in his words, work for everyone, not just a wealthy few, inferring that that's what the Republican message is all about. Many people believe that. How do you respond?
Well, I would say that we've heard this rhetoric from President Obama since he was elected and took the oath of office back in January. I would hope that he would challenge the Senate Democrats and say, look, let's pass a budget. It's been 1,000 days since the Senate Democrats passed a budget. Now, think about that. 1,000 days ago tomorrow, Rod Blagojevich was indicted. And think about all of the things that have happened. There hasn't been a budget passed out of the United States Senate for 1,000 days. Now, there's not a viewer that's watching us right now that lives their life or runs their business on that same way. So I think the president has an opportunity to admonish his colleagues in the Senate to say, look, Harry Reid, it's time to lead. Let's get off of this sort of just campaign rhetoric, and let's move forward and find common ground. And I think that's where the public is.
Real quickly, we don't have a lot of time, but let's talk about one of your colleagues, Congresswoman Gabrielle Giffords. Mm. She says she's going to step down. It's the best interest of Arizona. What do you think about that?
I think there's a lot of pain and a lot of difficulty in that journey, and she has been poignant and beautiful and strong as she has advocated for her district. And I think it's a very difficult season and a very difficult choice that she's making.
Absolutely. Will you be sitting next to a Democratic colleague?
Hey, I'm just going to be happy to have a seat seat there and come what may. We'll
All
see.
Right. We'll see what happens.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here this morning. Thanks.
Congressman Peter Roskam. Over to Mark Strong.
Good morning, guys.